Morning, Beaufort High. I'm not Lucy.
I'm not Ashton. It's February 12th.
And this is not your Beaufort High Morning News.
Yeah, it is. It is. A drive down Rebo Road in Beaufort reveals the landscape campus of the Technical College of the Lowcountry, a campus divided by the road with natural waters on both sides of the campus. The site was not always a state-owned community college. It was originally Mather School, a school founded by Rachel Crane Mather of Boston shortly after the Civil War to educate the daughters of the formerly enslaved people. Miss Crane Mather believed that everyone deserved an opportunity for a good education. She taught and raised money for the school. The first three students graduated from elementary school in 1901. In 1932, the South Carolina State Department of Education approved the high school program, and the school became Mather Industrial School. A junior college department was added, and male students were allowed prior to 1954. In 1955, the school was accredited by the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools, and in 1956, the first class of Mather Junior College graduated. The school entered into a pilot program to help prepare high school graduates for college. A merger occurred with Benedict College in 1968, and the campus was given to the state of South Carolina as a trade school. The Mather School became known as the Beaufort Region Training Center in 1970 and later became a part of the state technical college system. It was called Beaufort Technical College prior to 1988, when the name was changing to the Technical College of the Lowcountry. The site of the current Technical College of the Lowcountry continues to provide education opportunities for all people. This has been a moment in Black history.
Surprise your Valentine with a rose from the chocolate tree. These custom chocolate lollipops will be available during lunches all this week for $3. Don't miss this unique opportunity to say I love you.
The placement test for TCL will be offered on March 9th and 12th. Students must sign up in guidance by March 6th.
This is the final week for applications for AP Capstone. Completed application forms must be turned in to Ms. Corbett by Tuesday, February 18th to be considered for admission for next year.
Freshman Student Council is hosting a spirit night at Brody's on February 13th from 5 to 10 p.m. Hope to see you there.
Students traveling with Ms. Kidd on the Greece and Italy spring break trip will meet today after school in Ms. Kidd's room. Please see Ms. Kidd for more information.
There will be a meeting at 6 p.m. on Tuesday, February 18th to discuss details of the trip to see the 2021 presidential inauguration. The meeting will be in Mr. Miller's room. Please RSVP by Thursday, February 13th to secure your spot.
Students interested in visiting New Zealand, Australia, and Hawaii during the summer of 2021 need to see Mr. Miller. There will be an interest meeting on Tuesday, February 25th in Mr. Miller's room from 6 to 7 p.m. Please RSVP by Thursday, February 21st to secure your spot.
NHS members will pack health kits immediately after school day in Ms. Lacombe's room.
Hey Eagles, time for sports. The Beaufort Eagles wrestling team traveled to North Bernal Beach for the third round of the state team duels tournament. They had a great effort, but came up short, as North Myrtle Beach came out with 42-31 victory. Each time Beaufort looked like it might make a run, North Myrtle Beach found a way to stifle through Eagles' momentum. Gaining victories by pin, Beaufort were Peyton Bain, Matthew Durrance, and John Legree. Also gaining solid victory by points were Gary Bain, James Dagan, and Michael Cincy. Up next for the wrestling team is the lower state tournament at Bluffton on February 21st and 22nd for the individual qualifying. Today, girls lacrosse will play a scrimmage match at home against Savannah Christian at 6:30. JV and varsity softball will travel to Battery Creek for scrimmage games at 5 and 7. That's your sports news. Go Eagles!
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated for a moment of silence.
Thanks for watching.
Catch you later.